मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई हैव कम अप विद योर नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज दैट इज़ 4.4। इन दैट वी हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट द नेचर ऑफ द रूट्स। एज यू हैव ऑलरेडी सीन दैट देर आर सम क्वेश्चंस इन विच द रूट्स आर कमिंग सेम, इन सम क्वेश्चन देर आर रूट्स आर कमिंग डिफरेंट, इन सम क्वेश्चन देर इज़ नो रूट। सो हाउ टू डायरेक्टली गेट द नेचर ऑफ द रूट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी। So you all know the general equation of the form quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c. Now there is one terminology that we call a discriminant. In this discriminant we have to find this, that is b square minus 4ac. If you see this properly you will remember the quadratic formula. In that also we use this in under the root b square minus 4ac. From there only it has been taken. Now class, that I will tell you later how. Now class, see, there are three cases. Case number one, that is d is greater than 0, either d is equals to 0 or d is smaller than 0. If d returns, that is discriminant is greater than 0, then it will real and unequal roots will come. If d is equals to 0, exactly equals to 0, then real and equal roots can come. Real you can say, rational you can say, that's not a problem. Now talking about smaller than 0, then no roots. And these roots are also known as the imaginary roots. So class, again I am repeating, first of all we have to find the discriminant. Then we have to check these three conditions. It is greater than 0, that is positive value, equals to 0, smaller than 0, that is negative value. So after that we can analyze whether it is a real root or unreal, that is imaginary. Now class, let's move to one example. I have taken this example for you. This example says 2x square minus 7x plus 5 has the real roots or not. So class, first of all we have to find out a, b and c. That you can make out a, b and c. After that I have solved this discriminant, and after solving I am getting 25, that is greater than 0. So it is what? It is greater than 0 means this one part, that is real and unequal roots. Now class, what we have to do after this? If it is a real root, then we can determine the roots also. How we will determine the roots? See in this question. You know this formula. This formula is of Dharacharya. That is quadratic formula. Now what we will do, in place of this b square minus 4ac we can write d also. So value of d in our question, it was coming 25. So on solving, the root of 25 it is 5. Now what we have to do, we have to take first time plus then minus, as we were doing in quadratic formula also in finding the roots. So finally the answer is 3. 7 plus 5 divided by 4, it's 3, and 7 minus 5 divided by 4 is 1/2. So what we have got in this question, we have determined first whether it is a real or unequal roots. If it is a real and unequal root, then we can determine the roots also in this way. So class, in first question you have to do the same in exercise. Find the nature of the root of the following quadratic equation. If real root exists, find them. So class, this one, the first one, now see, in this, first of all it is compared with this equation, then a, b, c we have determined. After that discriminant d we have find out, and it is coming smaller than 0. So no real root is possible. So in this we cannot determine the roots because no real root is there. But if it is a real root, that is if it is greater than 0, then we can use the Dharacharya, as I have told you in previous example. So class, let's move to next question. Other party will do yourself a first question. Now, question number 2. In this, we have to find the value of k if their roots are equal. So for equal root, I have already told you in this first one, for equal roots, this equal roots, discriminant should be equals to 0. So in this question, it is already given that it's a equal roots, having two equal roots. So we will take discriminant equal to 0. So in this again, this is the equation. So ABC is 2, K and 3. So this is 2K and 3. So after substituting the value, we are getting this. So for equal roots, discriminant should be equals to 0. That is k square minus 24 is equals to 0. That is k square is equals to 24. That is k equals to plus minus this, and after solving we are getting plus minus 2 root 6. So this is the value of k which can be substituted in place of this to get our equal roots. I hope you all are getting this. Now this question, second part of it. In this, it is not given directly a quadratic equation. First of all, we have to multiply and form a quadratic equation. Now you can see that coefficient of x square is k, coefficient of x is minus 2k, and coefficient of c is 6. After that, again they have done the same process, discriminant, and discriminant is coming like this. Now for equal roots, we have to put equal to 0. Now after that, they have solved for the value of k and we are getting two values, that is 0 and 6. But 0 we cannot put here. If we put here 0, then what will happen? It will be no more a quadratic equation. It will not be a quadratic equation. This is only given. So value of k satisfying is 6. There are some cases where both the values will not satisfy. So you have to check. So here we have checked. After substituting, k is equals to 0, x square coefficient will get removed. So that's why this will not be a quadratic equation. So finally the answer is this one, 6. You all have got, class. Check it once again. First of all, forming a quadratic equation, then comparing, then discriminant, then property of equal roots, then finally the value, and out of these, k is equal to 0 is not satisfying, k equals to 6 is satisfying. Now there are 2-3 questions only. So now next question number 3. Question is given as, is it possible to design a rectangular mango groove whose length is twice its breadth and the area is 800. So first of all, we have to simply form a quadratic equation, then we will check. So forming a quadratic equation, first of all, they have considered the breadth as this and length as this, as according to the question. Now area will be length into breadth. So this, now area is given as 800 according to the question. So 2L square is equals to this. Now on solving, we are getting L square minus 400 is equals to 0. Now on comparing with this equation, we are getting A equals to 1, B equals to 0, and C equals to, because there is no coefficient of X, there is no term of x only, so that's why b is equals to 0. Now after that, discriminant is 600, that is greater than 0, so it have real roots, hence the desired rectangular mango group has designed to this plus minus 20. Negative cannot be a length, so answer is 20, and breadth is 20 and length is this. I hope you all are understanding. The equation was L square minus 400. So in this you can see that there is no L, that is x part is not there, middle term is not there, so that's why they have taken b is equals to 0, this, and after that discriminant, that is equal to greater than 0. So we can find the value of L. L, how they have determined? Using that, using a plus b, a minus b property. In this one they have used this one, they have used L square minus 20 square, that is L plus 20, L minus 20. After that they have got this equation. So plus, in this way you have to do, see this video again and again, then you will be able to understand. Now next question is also same. We have to check for the situation that sum of the ages of two friends is 20. 4 years ago the product of their ages in year was 48. So sum of the ages is 20, so if one is x then another is 20 minus x. You know that sum mein we have to consider one as x and another as 20 minus x. On adding these two you will get 20 only. Now 4 years later first friend was x, so 4 years later he will be of x minus 4. Similarly second friend is this, so he will be 20 minus x minus 4, that is 16 minus x. Now now product of their ages as given in question is 48. Now simple solving and we are getting this quadratic equation. Again we will check for the discriminant. For that we have to get the value of a, b and c. A, b and c. After that discriminant. Then discriminant is coming as negative. Discriminant is coming as negative. So no roots, no real roots, so we can this in this situation we cannot find the age of two friends. That's all class. Now only your last question is left. I want you to try and send me within this hour only. You try and solve these questions within this hour only. That's all class. And some of you are still not sending the work. So class, you have to see to it. You are in board class. Again and again I'm telling you, this time will never come back again, so you have to see to it, be serious about it. Many of you are not sending work at all, their presence is not registered, sometime they are not available online, so all this problem will be of yours later on. That's all class. Sort out your problem and discuss with me wherever you are finding difficulties.